Today's video is episode 3 of our Madden Ultimate Team free offensive guide series. And what today's video is going to do is it's going to teach you how to use the shotgun bunch from the Kansas City Chiefs playbook in Madden NFL 16. For those of you guys that are just stumbling upon our YouTube channel and are new, I want to introduce myself and our community here. My name is Cody, and our goal at this YouTube channel is to help you improve in Madden NFL 16. And we do that through a variety of video content. But what we're doing today is the first time I've ever done this series. And basically what we're doing is we're going to give you a free offensive and defensive guide. And it's kind of themed around being productive in Madden Ultimate Team specifically. And it can be productive in any type of Madden, but it really is built for Madden Ultimate Team. Now, yesterday we talked about your depth chart, and then the video before we kind of introduced the guide. And today we're getting into the playbook. So if you missed those videos, you could check out the playlist in the link below. That's going to give you access to all of the video content from this series. And so you make sure that you check that out. And also, guys, if you like what you see today, I highly recommend that you subscribe. But anyways, guys, without any more ado, I want to get into the playbook. So what we're going to do is we've loaded up the New England Patriots playbook on defense. This is a very popular playbook that a lot of guys are using. Now, we want to make sure that we have our best guys in here for the Seahawks. And let's see. So we need to make sure we get those subbed in. Now, what I'm going to do, and this is just to help show things, I'm going to actually sub in some poor defensive tackles because in practice mode, for some reason, you get a lot quicker block shed. So I'm going to take all those guys out, and then I am going to have the best secondary possible. So we got Jeremy Lane out there. We got Chancellor, but we're going to move him back to his original place at safety, and we're going to put a corner in there. And then of course we've got Sheed and Sherman on the outside here. All right, so the first formation we're going to be talking about today is the shotgun bunch, and we're going to be showing you just a little free Madden Ultimate Team guide here. Now, this playbook here from the shotgun bunch, the first thing that's always important when you're looking at your base, and again, guys, the shotgun bunch week falls under our category of base offense. And what base offense is designed to do is it's kind of your core. It's like chapters 2 through kind of 7 in a book, and it's like the meat of the book, really. And this is the meat of your offensive scheme. Now, what we like to do with this, whenever you're kind of dissecting a formation and starting to learn it, one of the first things you want to learn is where everybody goes. So as you can see, your number one receiver is going to go on this bunch side of a guy. Your number two receiver is going to be soloed out here to the left. Your tight end is going to be right here. And then your number three receiver is going to be right here. And of course, your running back is in the backfield. Now, that's the basic format of a bunch formation. The next thing that you want to do is take a look here. If you look at the bottom left of the play call screen, you're going to see that there's a packages option, and you can access that by moving the right stick right and left. And so here we're just going to flick it to the left, and we're going to see that it's going to give us a dual tight end package. If we flick it to the left again, it's going to give us a backup quarterback. Again, flicking it to the left, it's going to get a strong slot package. And what the strong slot package is going to do is going to put your primary receiver at the slot receiver. So as you can see in this picture here, Amari Cooper moves to the inside, and your number three receiver is going to move to the outside. Moving to the left again, and you see that it's going to, if you hit the spell halfback package, it's going to put your backup running back in the backfield. The strong solo package is going to put your number one receiver on the solo side, on the left side of the screen, and it's going to move your number two receiver to the far right receiver in the bunch set. And then if you go to the big package, it's going to create a, basically what it's going to do is it's going to put tight ends in that bunch side. Halfback solo, this is an interesting package, especially if you have a really good receiving halfback. It's going to put your running back on the far left of the screen in the solo slot, and then it's going to sub in your backup running back into the backfield. And then on the far right, as you can see here, your number one receiver remains the far right receiver in the bunch, but your number two receiver now becomes the slot receiver. So that's the packages, and that's all the packages that we have access to. None of these really do a ton for us in terms of, like, you know, you can maybe get a running back at tight end or a tight end at wide receiver kind of thing. You can actually sub in all of these guys. Okay, so for me, I don't really use any of these packages, but the way to sub players in, I want to go ahead and, you know, debunk that right now, is you just hit R1 and then you just go to wherever you want them. So, like, for example, if I wanted to put Latavius Murray's backup running back in for like a third down situation, then I would come to his selection and then I'd put Roy Helu Jr. in. Okay, so it's very simple to do it, but I know that some of you guys may not know how to do that, so I wanted to go ahead and break that down. So that's a lot of stuff for introductory material to the Shotgun Bunch Week, but the next thing that I want to do is I want to talk about universal things that you can do out of the Shotgun Bunch Week. Guys, these videos are going to be a little bit longer because they're full formation breakdowns, so I hope that you guys have allocated a little bit more time to watching them. Of course, you can pause them at any moment and go back and rewatch it, but anyway, so the first thing that we want to discuss is basic things that you can do from pretty much any play in this formation, some of the features that this formation allows. So to do this, we're just going to pick any play, any play, and we're going to use the play stick just because those are some very basic routes, as you can see. Now, one of the other important things to do whenever, you know, understanding the formation is to understand your quick audibles. So I just quickly want to run through them here. We have spacing, halfback base, verticals, and play action post. Now, this is one of the main reasons we actually selected Kansas City to be a Madden Ultimate Team based ebook, and the reason is because their quick audibles are very effective, and in Madden Ultimate Team you cannot set your quick audibles. Now, if we were just playing in a regular head-to-head match, online head-to-head match, you would be able to set your quick audibles, but unfortunately the Madden Ultimate Team game mode does not allow us to, so we have this, we have what the game gives us. So one of the first things that's important to do is kind of see where you can motion everybody. So, for example, this is why I like to use the play spacing, because it's an easy play, stick, because nobody's on a blue route or anything, so you can motion pretty much anywhere you want. So the first one that we want to learn is that we can motion the halfback to the right, and he's going to go to the right side of the formation, as you can see here. The second thing is we can motion him to the left side, and he's going to go into the slot. Now, one key little feature here is if your running back's blocking, when you motion him into the slot, you see that his route becomes a hitch route. So that's something that's kind of important to understand. The next thing that we want to kind of understand is where can we motion our tight end. As you can see here, we can only motion him to the left side. And when we motion him to the left side, he's going to become this tight end, kind of split wing back tight end right here on this left side. The next thing that's important to notice is where can you motion your far outside receiver. And here you see that we can motion him to the right. We can actually motion him, and we can also actually motion him to the left side of the screen. So as you can see here, we can bring him across to the left side, and he's going to be a slot. He's going to become a slot receiver. And then, these guys on the line, you do want to kind of see where you can motion them as well. Normally, they're not as important because they're on the line of scrimmage, which means that they're going to take a little bit longer to do their motion, and you can't really do motion snaps with them. So here you see that we can motion him to the left side, and it's going to kind of create, again, that same kind of alignment here. And then the other thing is that you can motion him to the right side, which is going to make it basically becomes a basic standard trips formation. But you do see you can motion him to the right. And then finally, you can motion this wide receiver here, Crabtree. You can motion him to the inside, and it's going to create kind of like a split close with a bunch. It's like a bunch close type of formation, and it's actually really it can be beneficial in some avenues. So this is what you have as your availability for motioning your receivers. Now, when we get into play break, when we get into universal things that you can do, this is kind of a crucial thing to think about. And so these are all the motions that you can do. Now, I want to show you two man under from this formation. And what you're going to see is that a lot of guys, what they'll do is they'll man a line and they'll press their two man under. This is the best way possible to run two man under out of anything that you can do here. And what you're going to see here is the basic alignment is it's going to put three slot corners on your right side bunch, and then your running back's going to be lined up typically with a typically against a linebacker. Okay, so those are some basic principles to understand with the bunch formation. So now what we want to do is we want to do some play breakdowns. And the key to the bunch, in my experience, is to use a lot of motion. I think that's always important. But also, the key is that a lot of guys are going to use this right side of the screen. So the key to the bunch really becomes this left side of the screen. Being able to have passing plays that go in a multitude of different directions. Okay, so with that in mind, guys, we want to first break down our base play. So the core play for this is very similar to our St. Louis Rams offensive playbook guide. And the core base play, if you will, is this play here. It's called Kansas City Divide. And I want to show you why real quick. So the primary route on this play is this speed out to Amari Cooper. Now, I want to show you what it does when you motion it to the outside. So again, a lot of people like to do this man line and press. Now, the one vulnerability to the man line and press is what it does is it now gives you outside leverage on the defense. So what we're going to do here, the key to this outside out route is to have outside leverage on whatever they're running. Okay, so our goal here is to motion him in such a way that's going to give him outside leverage. So I want to show you a couple of examples. So this is the first one. If they're just man aligning and pressing their coverage, that's your cue, and you don't have to motion him very far, just one step motion and he's going to work. And you're going to see that when he cuts to the outside, you want to pass it. Now, you don't want to use any pass lead unless you're going against zone coverage. Now, this was a really hard lesson for me to learn, and it took a while for me to really work this out. But basically, if you're facing man-to-man coverage, you're going to want to throw this with no pass lead. And the reason is because if you throw it with pass lead, it has a better chance of being an inaccurate throw from any quarterback in the game, not just poor quarterbacks. So what you're going to see is this is the key here, and this is a really hard thing to teach, I think, but hopefully you can see it in the instant replay here. We're having some issues. But basically what you're going to see here is you're going to see here this outside position here. So you can kind of see it a little bit here. We'll try to move it in such a way. So this is really a good example. So if you take a look here, Richard Sherman's left foot is not lined up. And so if we move this in a little bit, what you're going to be able to see here is we have basically a outside leverage. That's how you get it, okay? The motion is the outside leverage. Now, what I want to do is I want to show you the route. So the timing on the route, where do you want to throw the ball? So you want to throw this right as he cuts here. So you kind of anticipate it. And when he plants, he's going to plant his right foot into the ground and cut to the outside. So here, I'm already throwing it here, and that's because I've ran this several times. You want to run these plays several times before you actually run them in game. But here he plants, and you see the ball's already thrown. And what it's going to do is it's just going to be a quick out route. Now, what we like to normally do is use the possession catch. It's probably the most popular catching animation I use with this. And it's going to be a nice tap toe on the outside for a first down. So that's the key to the first motion snap. Now the second motion snap is if they're running, for example, if they manually move the guy out. So what you'll see from time to time, especially as you play advanced players, is they will start to manually move their corner outside to like kind of this position here. And what that's going to do is if you ran your standard motion snap, it's going to give him the outside leverage. So in a scenario like this, you're going to motion him to the point where he gets the outside leverage. So here we're going to motion him a little bit more, but he still gets that outside leverage, and we're able to get the ball to him, and that's where that possession catch comes in. And I'm sorry I didn't go against man coverage there. I want to show you against man. So again, here, and they're just going to move him to the outside to give him a little better chance at getting outside position, but you're going to motion your receiver just a little bit farther here, and it's going to give him that outside position, And there we got a bad throw. And as you can see, it is. You do need a little bit of a decent quarterback. Derek Carr's not the best quarterback to be throwing this with. I find a quarterback with good deep accuracy and good medium accuracy is important. But here it is. And again, just when he lights up, that's when you want to throw it. When your icon lights up, you throw the ball. That's kind of the basic rule of thumb here. But what you're going to see is you're going to see the same result. Basically, again, we're just trying to get that outside position. So right here, we come to the outside. And again, we have that. As you can see, Sherman is basically inside of Amari Cooper. At the snap of the ball, that's what you need. And you're going to see you're able to easily deliver the ball to the outside. Okay, so that's the basic principle in terms of beating man-to-man coverage. Now, one other thing that I want to show you is against man-to-man coverage, one of the blessings with this route is if it doesn't get pressed, you don't even have to motion it. So there are some instances where you may want to motion somebody else. If they're off coverage like this, you don't have to motion Amari Cooper. As you can see here, man coverage and he's off, we're able to easily still get that animation, right? Now, I want to talk about zone coverage. So, another thing that your opponent's going to do is he will do cover three. And what he's going to say is he's going to say, okay, I need this flat zone from Cam Chancellor to stop that route. Well, basically, it's the same rule of thumb. If Amari Cooper is outside of Cam Chancellor, then he's going to be able to do a good job. So they may show this play as two men under and hope that you think it is, and they're going to try to trap you. Was again, your alignment here, you need to get him outside of Cam Chancellor. So again, just motion him a little bit. He gets outside of Cam Chancellor, and you're just going to throw it to that sideline. Now, again, a good throw, that's going to be a catch, and we'll try to show you that one more time to show you that it is consistent, and it is consistently effective. So just a little motion out, and there you see the possession catch. The flat zone doesn't cover it. So, suffice all of that to say this, the only coverage that can stop this route to Amari Cooper is a base aligned cover two. And the reason that that is so is because against base aligned coverage, so if I'm in a base aligned coverage, you're going to see this. You see, this is the alignment. This outside corner on the far right is so far outside that I can't possibly get outside positioning. So for example, if I motion Cooper all the way to the outside, you're going to see that that Richard Sherman still has outside position. Okay, I'm still technically inside. So what this means is that if Sherman is in a flat zone, then he's going to be able to defend this route to Amari Cooper. As you can see, it really creates a very difficult throw. Now, there are actually very rare scenarios, but you can kind of sneak this ball in, but it is kind of dicey. So I just want to show you it a couple times here. See there, and there Sherman plays the ball. And that's what you're looking for as a defense, right? Well, one thing that I'm trying to do to kind of work on this route to make it even better is if they were to do this, what I'm going to try to do, if I have to, is hold a high pass lead and pass lead it up. And it's going to basically become an aggressive catch animation. Now, and what that's going to do is it's going to put your catch and traffic rating and spectacular catch rating up against his zone coverage rating. So here we'll show it to you again. And again, you're just going to step up and pass lead it up. And oftentimes, you'll get bad throws. You'll get aggressive catching. So cover two does the best job out of any of these. Now, what if he's in, for example, what if he takes his cover three style coverage and makes it into kind of a cover three cloud and puts the Sherman card, or the Sherman in a, he puts Sherman into a hook zone, right? Well, we're going to show you that real quickly. It's similar. But you can actually still fit this ball in to Amari Cooper if he's in a hook zone. It's only a flat zone. Okay? Now, that's cool because what it does for your offense is it allows you to work off some other routes. Okay? So, for this play call, What we want to do here is we want to just say, okay, now what can we do off of this route to Amari Cooper that's going to make it successful against cover two? Because that's the primary defense that's going to beat it. Baseline cover two, again. So what I find is important is to take Michael Crabtree and place him on a streak. And the reasoning behind that is if they're in a cover two, what that's going to mean is that they're going to be in a flat zone, something like this, right? This is basic alignment for cover two. Now, our back here, Latavius Murray, I normally like to place him on an option route. And the reasoning is because against man-to-man, he's going to cut it out to an out route. And against zone coverage, he's going to become a curl route. And it's going to help us with this route to Holmes. So what we're going to do here is we run the play and we realize that it's cover two. And one thing we can do is outside is this, it's kind of a sketchy pass lead this season. It doesn't really work. Is the straight streak up the sideline to Crabtree doesn't really work in this year's game, to be quite honest with you. The really only reason it's there is if they, for example, take a safety away. You know, so if they commit to using Earl Thomas, we now have a one-on-one with Michael Crabtree up top. Another thing that this route's going to do is it's going to clear out a lot of space for Andre Holmes to run underneath him. So against cover two, the route that we really like most of the time is this deep crossing route to Holmes. Another thing that I like to do against sometimes, especially if they're running a lot of zone coverage, this is something I've actually increasingly started doing, is placing this outside guy here, Crabtree, on a little smoke screen. And the reason that I do this is because he's going to hold that flat zone really well, and it's going to allow you to sneak in this deep crossing pattern. Okay. Now, again, this is kind of tender, and normally baseline cover two is normally the defense that does give this play some trouble. Okay. So Marcel Reese's route becomes kind of important to the baseline cover two, because that's what people are going to run, right? Well, if Marcel Reese is on his route, what you're going to see here is you can actually kind of maybe do a little aggressive catch action to that as well, but nothing really. And again, this is to say, when you get a look that is the baseline cover two look, then you need to adjust your play call, okay? But normally the way this play will work is you're going to be forcing them to cover Amari Cooper. Now I want to show you this against, say, for example, a basic cover three. And what you're going to find is against a basic cover three defense, this crossing pattern becomes a really nice late read for you. As you can see there, against the cover three, it gets into a void in the zone. It does a nice job. And even against the cover two, and we'll show you that here. And if you're really worried about the cover two, one thing also I like to do is just take Murray, put him on a basic out route, and he's going to hold that flat zone down for you. So here you're going to see it. They run cover two, and you see you're able to fit that crossing pattern in very late in the play, but still a read. So that's what we're looking at, and that's cover three and cover four. Now again, this is all the while understanding that Amari Cooper's route is open against the cover three. As you can see, as long as he gets that outside position, he's open, right? All right, so that is the divide wheel play. There's a lot more that I can say about this play. Let me show you the left side stuff against man coverage. So the out route normally doesn't get great separation because Murray doesn't have great route running. The crossing pattern, however, normally does a good job. It also depends on your route running, but normally it does do a pretty good job here. Sometimes you have to, you know, sometimes you don't want to throw it. It's a read. You need to look and see if it's open. And then, of course, if they go, you know, with like a heavy pressure blitz type of look here, because this is possible, and if they try to press you out of this and go man blitz, I like to lob it up and use the aggressive catch mechanic to get a nice one-on-one with Michael Crabtree. So that's the basics of this set here, of the base play. Now, what we want to do now is have a play that is going to do a good job against cover two baseline, right? that's the second type of kind of installment. So we do. And the play that we like to use against baseline cover two, one of them, we have several, but one of the plays we like to use against baseline cover two is this play, KC Drive. Right? And so KC Drive does a really good job for us. So they baseline their defense, and this is what it looks like. Now, what we like to do is we want to make it look the same as if it were the divide out or the divide wheel play, right? So what we do here is we like to take Holmes and we want to put him on. You can put him on a streak. I've put him on a streak. Normally, that's what I'll do. And then you want to take Amari Cooper. And you could actually leave him on this drag, but normally what I like to do is take him and put him on a hitch route. And what that's going to do is it's just going to give you some good spacing to run this. And so you motion him out like you normally would, except you let him go all the way to the outside. Now against baseline cover two. And then again, I leave Crabtree on this streak, but another thing that I like to do is put him on a slant if you have time to get that hot route in. And what you're going to see here is against the cover two, you're going to be able to hit Marcel Reese in this deep corner area of the field. So I want to go into instant replay and show you kind of how this works. But basically what you'll see here is Cooper's going to hold this flat zone. The deep vertical is going to take the streak, right? And then the only thing left is to get this yellow zone by 27 here. And so we do that with the slants. As you can see, he's starting to break down on the slants here and the in route to the running back. And you see that it's going to give you a window to hit this deep corner route. So that's how I normally beat the baseline cover two. That's one of the ways, right? And so we do this a lot. We call this play a lot because, you know, normally guys will go to that baseline cover two once they see that that's your main read. Now you can actually smart route this hitch route and you can actually still have some success. Now the reason why would you smart route the hitch route? Well, a couple of reasons. The first one being that it's going to beat man to man. The second one being that it's going to make him just more of a threat as a receiver. So here they go cover two. We run that hitch route. And you can see you can still get that ball to Marcel Reese over the top. I don't do any pass lead to that route. One thing that you might consider doing is a pass lead vertically. I find that to do a really good job in the instance that some guys may be running heavy defenses. That vertical pass lead is going to get him right in that zone kind of idea. So you can definitely do those things. But that's the basic setup for this play. Now, this play will also beat your cover three. It's basically going to beat any baseline defense. And that's why I like this play. Because it does a good job of countering everything else we're doing. So if they go to cover three, right? So you set it up just as is, as normal. And what you're going to see is R1 should be able to beat this cover three to the outside. Now, against the cover three, we don't do any pass lead at all. And you see it does a good job. Now, some guys, if they're advanced in their defensive schematics, are going to play over-the-top passing coverage. And in the event that they do that, what you're going to see emerge is Amari Cooper's route will become a really good option to throw the ball to because they're going to stay high. Well, actually, here they don't for some reason. I don't know what happened on that play. But the basic idea is that they're going to play over top coverage and they're going to prevent your corner route, right? And what it's going to do is it's going to leave Amari Cooper open for a quick flat of about, 5 to 6 yards. And also it's going to leave your underneath route to Murray open. Okay? So that's one way that we run this play. That's not every way we run it, but that is one way. The next way that I run this play is I run it as a man beater. A lot of times you'll face man coverage and they'll start to key on certain routes and they'll start to overplay them. So what you may see online is that they will start doing this. So they'll base a line and press their two-man under. What that's going to do is going to leave man-to-man assignments on everybody. And then they'll say, okay, I know that you're running the out route, so I'm just going to drop Sherman into the flat zone and leave everything as is. Well, excuse me, in the event that they do that, that's where this play comes into play. So what we'd like to do here is the same basic principle. We're going to put Holmes on a streak route, and we're going to motion Murray to the right side of the screen. Now, when he gets over here, of course, we're going to snap the ball fairly quickly. And I like to put Crabtree on a slant route. I find the slant route to be a really good route to kind of hold zones for the drag route. And so we do that, and what you're going to see here emerge is man coverage. Now, as you can see there, Murray's route, you don't always throw that against man. Again, you need a good route running back. If you don't have a good route running back, then it's not going to work for you. But here we show you, if they give us inside leverage, we normally call this play, and you're going to be able to hit these underneath crossing patterns and have a pretty good time with this. This is a really simple read, but in my opinion, it does a lot for you. And again, just this quick out. And then the tight end corner route normally wins as well because Marcel Reese has 81 route running, right? So that's kind of the basics for this play. And there's more to it as well, but that's the basics. Moving to the next play call that we make out of the huddle. And that is the play. So normally what they'll try to do, once you start establishing those two kind of key power plays, if you will, they're going to run a lot of plays to shut down your corner route. So they're going to run a lot of outside type of zone coverages to shut down that right side of screen. And normally what you'll find is that they will begin to user control that side of the field. So to take advantage of that, we go to this play here, Z spot. And this is an oldie but a goodie, but it's something that I'm increasingly liking a little bit more, and I think it has a lot of good things to add for this playbook. All right, so Z spot. Now, against man-to-man coverage, it's not a very good play this season. It really isn't. But against zone coverage, it does provide you with some options. So first and foremost, what you're going to see is that you're going to have a couple of different options with this play. And the first thing that I like to do is take my running back here, and I like to put him on a streak route. Now, as you can see, basically what's going to happen is he's going to go up into the seam, kind of replacing Crabtree's route as he comes across, right? And then the next thing that I like to do is I like to take this guy, Holmes, and I like to place him on a smart routed hitch route. And as you can see, it's going to allow you to underneath kind of curl routes, right? And then finally, I like to put my tight end on just a basic drag route. The reason for that is it's going to give me kind of a man-to-man bailout route if they do go man. It's also going to do a couple of things for the zone coverage portion of this. So if they go man-to-man, I do want to show you. Your route here to Marcel Reese normally is going to win. As you can see, it's just a rack catch, and you're going to have some pretty good success with that for a couple of yards, really. Now, again, you don't want to call this if you think they're running man-to-man. You want to call this kind of if they're running some, you know, heavy zone coverages. And then, again, here, this route to X to Holmes with a low pass lead is normally going to work, assuming that he catches the football. But the key here is against zone coverage. So if they go to the cover three, what you're going to see emerge is this, basically what we're looking to hit here. And Carr's not going to be able to hit it probably because he doesn't have great throw power, or excuse me, deep accuracy. And you may want to put Holmes on a streak, actually. So here we'll put Holmes on a streak here instead of a hitch route. If you think it's man, you want to put him on a hitch. But if you think it's zone, you don't. But like this is what we're seeing here, right? Now they go cover three. And the goal is to get Crabtree open, right? So we just It takes a while. And here we're actually going to get, and honestly, we probably need to back the defense up. It's a very long developing route, so you don't want to throw it if they're pressuring you a lot. But basically, this is the idea here. So they go to cover three, you step up in the pocket, and you see that what's going to happen is Crabtree, when he cuts underneath, he's going to come underneath like that. That's what you're looking to get. Now, normally against cover three, it's very consistent. When they start running things like cover four, it doesn't become as consistent. But again. And because you haven't motioned anybody, this actually gives you an option. Another option that I like to do is put Murray on a wheel route and motion him to the outside. That's going to give you a nice man read, and it's going to help you in zone coverage. But that's basically what you're seeing there. Okay, so those are just some basic components of this play. This play is not really that good in terms of it gets a lot of calls. It's a very situational play call. It's really only against cover three that I like to do this play. But it's just like this. It's like you just have to wait so long for him to come open, unfortunately. Another thing that you can do with this play, this is something that actually is growing a lot in popularity, is if you take this route here to Holmes and move him to the left side of the screen, and then you take Murray and put him on a streak, and then, you know, you may throw the tight end on a streak as well, something like this, right? This is going to create a nice little really interesting play. But normally you're gonna easily hit this Crabtree route deep. So that's another option that you can have based on some of the motion things. And then finally, there's this. So if you take Murray, just put him on a streak, and then you're gonna actually motion him out of the backfield, and then also put Amari Cooper on a streak. So you have your, this is the ultimate zone beater in my opinion. If you know they're running a zone and they're not blitzing a whole lot of people, this is a great play. So they're going to be preoccupied with defending this stuff on the right side normally. And what that allows you to do, it's going to allow you to hit this route to Crabtree over the middle. And it's only two hot routes too, so that's nice. This is primary cover three. And Derek Carr can't even get it there. But that's just some basic concepts from there. This play doesn't get a whole lot of run, as you can probably see why. Because it's not that effective. It used to be one of the best plays in the game. And now it just isn't as effective because that post route doesn't do everything that it used to. All right, so moving on from that is... We've talked about KC divides, so now what I want to do is I want to talk about this play, Shotgun Bunch Trail. And this play actually does get some call. It's very similar to Z-Spot. And what we're going to do with this play is we're going to motion Crabtree to the inside. Now, you only want to call this play if they're running baseline, right? So... You know, if they come out and they're showing you this look, that's when you want to start calling a play like this. Right? So what you're going to do on this play is you're going to take Murray, you're going to put him on a streak. Okay? And then the other thing that you're going to do is you're going to take your circle receiver here, and you're going to place him on a hitch route instead of a drag route. Right, so this is the basic viewpoint. Now, if they go zone coverage, so for example, you'll probably see like cover three or cover two. What you're going to see here is you're going to be able to hit the running back with a nice matchup against a nice seam matchup. Right. The other thing that you're going to be able to do here, the key is to get this post route in a nice position for potential players that are going to call cover two. All right, right? So if they call cover two, this is where this play starts to kind of match what we want to do. So they call cover two here, and you're going to try to hit this post route up the seam. You see, that's what we want. That's what we want right there. That's the perfect example of what we want this to do. So if your opponent is calling baseline cover two, right, which is a defense they're probably going to call because of what you've been running from everything else, right, because of your divide wheel, that kind of play. The reason you bring this guy inside is against the cover two safety, right? Watch what happens. Now, this is pretty consistent. Earl Thomas is going to run with the deep vertical post route because the running back is kind of a delayed route out of the backfield. He doesn't really access information that it's coming. And so you're going to see here Earl Thomas is going to go to that route, and what it's going to do is it's going to leave this running back open for an outside pass lead, and you're going to be able to, you know, get going on your horse, and normally this is going to be a really big play. Now, I like to call this if they're calling baseline cover two. If they're not calling baseline cover two, I don't normally go to this play. But against the baseline cover two, this becomes a very effective play call, right? So here it is again, baseline cover two. And you see the same kind of thing. We pass led that to the left, and we're able to get in for six. Now, one way to also shore this play call up is to take Amari Cooper and put him on a slant route instead of a drag route or a hitch route. The only reason we put him on a hitch route is because of some other things that we were going to do from this. But after thinking about it a little more, I think that the hitch route's probably the best route. So anyway, here it is again. And again, it's very consistent, guys. This is baseline cover two, right? I mean, this is what everybody is going to run against you. Okay, so that is, in my opinion, a very nice option for you. And again, you have your quick reads. So, like for example, if they send pressure off the right edge, you know, you're going to be able to hit these crossing patterns underneath for a quick gain if you need to, quick 5-6 yards as well. But normally you're going to hit that post route. Now, if they go to cover three, I want to show you what happens on this play. If they go to cover three, so just leave, you know, you can either re-drag Amari Cooper, put him on a slant route, put him on a hitch route. He's really kind of an option receiver. You can do whatever you want with him. Put him on an in route. Anyway, if they go to cover three, right? So if they go to cover three, the same thing happens, as you can see. Now, that's actually a really nice thing because against baseline, it gives you a lot of options. Now, it makes them really think twice about baselining their coverage. So, in cover three, as you can see, this is what we're looking at. And we're going to bring Crabtree in here. All right, so this is our basic route combo. And as you see, cover three does kind of drop it down a little bit. And what you're going to want to do against the cover three is you're going to hit your crossers, right? You're underneath crossing patterns. Now, this route to Holmes, I actually thought about changing it because it doesn't do a whole lot for the play, but actually it does. So if we took Holmes and just put him on like a hitch route, right, it's going to change the way the play works against the cover two. Because they're going to be able to trade off. Well, I guess you still do get the animation, so. Eh. But anyway, that's what we have from that perspective, right? Now, another thing that, well, we don't really need to get into that now. So that's a bunch of stuff, and there's more to it as well. So another play that I like to use is the bunch, and I like to use, so if you're facing a lot of zone coverages, I really like this play. So the slip screen and the halfback cross screen, they're basically ran the same, they're ran for different purposes. So we have one more play I want to show you before I get into the screens, and that is the play These mesh plays are really good too. I'm not going to get into them today because I don't use them enough to really warrant it. Actually, no, we will. So let's go over mesh post briefly here. Okay, so this is mesh post, right? And we're all familiar with the way that these plays are kind of ran. And what we're going to want to do, though, is we're going to want to do a couple things with this. So I love the underneath mesh, and I want to keep it. But I'm going to take Marcel Reese, and I'm going to put him on a streak route. Now, this is predominantly for zone coverage purposes. So we're going to motion Amari Cooper out as if he was going on the drive out route, but now he's going to be on a post route, right? And the idea here is to get him open against zone coverage. So if they go zone, pass lead that up, and you're going to see that he's going to run underneath it like a really, and that's what you're looking for, right? Now again, if they go to cover three, so it's the same look here, but you're rolling out, and they go cover three, and you see that it's a big play potential. So that's why I like this play, right? It's another one of those things that if you, once you establish that you can beat man-to-man coverage, once you establish that you can, you know, that you can do a lot of good things, this play now becomes a really nice option, especially against like zone, because the zones won't cover it very well, right? Because of the every other route. Now, it is a little bit of a later read in the play in the route progression, unfortunately. And so you need these quick underneath mesh routes, right? So that's why we have them. So we read these quick underneath mesh routes, but normally we're going to hit this route to Amari Cooper, as you can see there. Crushes cover three, and they really have to use her the middle of the field to stop it. But again, we've been hitting them with so many good concepts to the right side that they, you know, they're going to be a little bit lenient of doing that. Another thing that we can do with this play, which is interesting, is we can also motion Amari Cooper to the left side of the screen. Now, when I do this, what I like to do is I like to take the square receiver and place him on a streak. And what you're going to see is it's going to create a nice little zone beating concept to that side of the field. And what I also like to do is take Reese and put him on a slant. And you see that this now makes another type of passing concept that you can utilize. And this is one that does a good job at beating cover two coverage, right? So if they go to their baseline cover two or their cover three or pretty much any zone coverage, this is going to do a good job. So let me show you the cover three briefly here. Right, so this is what you're going to be looking at. And circle is going to be able to do a good job normally of beating that cover three, as you can see. Okay. Let me try to think here if I wanted to talk about anything else from this, because this is a really nice play for you. No, I didn't get a good throw there. So one other thing I wanted to talk about from this specific play is how it does against man-to-man, right? So we do need to at least be aware of what we're getting ourselves into with man coverage. And that's why I recommend something like this, right? So you motion him out, and if you snap it right, you're not going to get bumped. But the thing is, these underneath drags normally beat man. They normally do. Now, not always. And in the event that they don't beat man, normally what we have happen. And another thing that you can do that's kind of cool is you can actually motion Cooper back in a couple steps and snap it. The cool part is it's going to make that unbumpable, and it normally gives him a decent shot against man-to-man, as you can see there. Now, another cool component about this mesh play is the route to the running back is really effective. So they go man-to-man, right? Your running back on this mesh route, when he cuts up field, is going to be a nice read. Now, as you can see there, he gets hit. He gets hit by the guy, by the safety, right? So, in order to do that, I'm going to pass lead hard to the left side, and you see he's going to be able to do it. Now, that's against Bobby Wagner, who clearly has better speed and better man coverage than he does. So, it is a very effective little route. So it's something that I really like to do. Another cool part about this play is you can still motion this back out, never be afraid to do this. This is a very good little read. It's a very good little concept. And it does a really nice job. It matches him up with a corner, unfortunately, but again, with a good route running back, it becomes a very nice little play. I'm trying to think here. See, I want to show you also how this motion snap works. So if they're in zone and you do the motion snap, you're still going to get it. It's just a very late read, unfortunately. So if they're base rushing, you need to hit those underneath drag routes. And as you can see, these underneath crossing patterns are easy reads to have. So this is a really good play. And I also want to show you mesh corner. So the cool part about the mesh play is that you can actually do it. You can do the same kind of concepts, but you can do it to the other side, right? So if we go with the basic play of mesh, what you're going to find, unfortunately, there is one little subtle difference. Actually, no, I'm sorry. You would want to use the play stick for this. You would actually want to use the play stick for this because it's going to give you everything you need to be effective. So let's use stick, right? It is kind of unfortunate because it's going to, you know, it is kind of a tell that you're running it if you do it from the mesh, basic mesh play. So this is stick, and what you get is you get this nice kind of post-type route to Cooper. If you motion to the left, it's going to turn into a post route, as you can see here. Now from there, we like to use the same concept that we use from the bunch trail, as we put Murray on a streak. We're going to bring Crabtree underneath on a drag route, and then we'll take Marcel Reese. Normally, we'll put him on a little streak, and then from there we'll leave Holmes on his little stick route. And what's going to happen here is against zone, you're going to get that same type of thing with the running back, as you can see, against that cover two. Unfortunately, it's not the best. If you smart route the stick route, like if it's like first and 10 and you smart route it, it becomes a little better. But like if we try to hit this route to circle, right, you're going to see that it's not really that good. So this is a very rare call in my playbook, but it is something I do use occasionally. And then what I wanted to do now is talk about the cross screens. I actually do have one other play, though, but I do want to come out in it. So halfback slip screen, right, that's a very good play. Screens are not quite as effective this year as they have been in years past, but they still do a lot for the offense, and we can actually incorporate them in our scheme. So your play action audible, I haven't even touched on it yet, the play action post. Now this is a play that we really love, and for several reasons. The crypt, it is not as good against man as I'd like it to be, but it still is very effective. So what we like to do with this play is we like to take the tight end, we like to put him on a streak route, and then we like to take the running back and we like to place him on an option pattern, and we're going to motion him to the right side of the screen. This motion is going to allow for a lot of things within this route, but it's going to really help the route develop as a whole. Now what you're going to see here is against your standard cover two, it actually does a pretty good job against it, as you can see. But against cover three, that's where this play becomes very effective. So against cover three, what you're going to see here is that X becomes a really nice option over the middle. As you can see, it's a big play type of play, right? And it's really mainly for cover three and cover two. The reason we spend so much time talking about how to beat those is because the base play is going to beat man, right? So that is the PA pose in a nutshell. That's what you're looking for. If they go man-to-man, you actually have some checkdowns with this one, so that's why it's a decent one, especially also because it comes in our quick audibles. But if they go man-to-man, this square route. If you pass lead that to the outside, normally it's going to have good separation for you. So that's why we use it. Now, the reason we use PA post is we have this slip screen as a backside kind of thing. And so what I often do is I will motion him to the right side of the screen. They're going to think I'm running PA post, right? I also slide my line to the left. And if they're in zone coverage, this is a really good option. You get a ton of blockers out there. I like to do the double juke back to the inside normally, and it gives me a nice option. Now, what it's going to do also is if they're sending heavy pressure at you, you can hit this quick flat route to Marcel Reese, right? Pretty simple. So that's pretty much that. If they go man, so if they like fool you and they go man, normally what I'll do is I'll just throw it away. Normally is what I'll do. Pretty simple, right? But that's how I use that. And then the play verticals. So this play has a several of different ways in which it can be ran. We've kind of exhausted the deep post over the middle kind of thing. So what I like to do with this is basically a check down read. So I take Murray here and I put him on a little swing pass to the right side of the screen, and I'm going to motion him to the outside. Now, again, zone coverage, he's my first read. It's just a quick pass. As you can see, if I see zone, it's just a little quick pass. And normally I do this against baseline cover two, you know, knock on wood. I mean, that's normally what I call it against. And again, it's just a quick little motion and then snap throw kind of thing. If you wait too long, it doesn't work, as you can see there. It doesn't quite work out as well. What I like to do is I like to put the tight end on a flat route as well. Normally that's kind of how I run it. And what it basically boils down to is, again, it's just snap, throw, and then you're going to get some lead blockers out in front of you. It's just a little quick makeshift screen type of thing. That's what I like to do. And that's really the first way I run the verticals play. The second way that I run the verticals play from here is I take Amari Cooper and I put him on a streak, and then I take Latavius Murray and I put him on a wheel route. And normally what this does is it just does a lot of damage against the zone coverage. You can pass lead Marcel Reese's right to the right against cover two, against cover three you'll see this here. So against cover three, you'll see that you can hit this deep post route if you have time in the pocket. And then again, you also have one-on-ones downfield. So that's why we like it. Spacing. So this is the key to the whole offense, really, and I saved it for last. Spacing is a really good play for quick passing. And basically what we do here is we're going to take Holmes here. We're going to put him on a hitch route and smart route it. That's our first go-to. And then what we also like to do here is we take Latavius Murray and we leave him on this pattern, this little block and release slip kind of thing. The only other thing we do, and we really just kind of leave everything as is. Another thing that I've kind of liked to do is take Crabtree and smart route his route, because you can do it because it's an option route. And basically against zone coverage, he's going to make it a curl. Against man coverage, he's going to make it a post. So in instances where we're facing heavy man, right, something like this where they're going to call man, we have quick reads here. So the first one is circle, and Amari Cooper, just a quick little read underneath, right? Nothing too complicated. It's simple, it's 5 yards, it's nothing crazy. The next read, though, and you only want to run this when it's first and 10 because it's going to give you the best route combo. But the second read is X, and you'll see that X here does a good job at snapping back animations as well. All right. Now, the key to this, though, is the way that it does a good job against zone coverage. Basically, this route to circle is going to be open all day. It's just a quick little read. It's just a quick 5 yard route, right? But it's open against every zone. So that's cover three. We'll show you here. This is cover two. And it's it's just a sit-down route. All right, just very simple, quick sit-down route, easy money. And it's just so effective, in my opinion. Just quick sit-down route, and you can catch it and run after the catch. Very easy to get in the zone, right? And the reason that this is so important, in my opinion, is because it just does a really good job of beating a lot of things people like to do. Now, if they were to go man coverage and they were to use her that left side, what you're going to see here develop is this quick route to the back. The cool part about that route is normally the guy guarding the running back will end up blitzing because he's going to read that running back as staying in the block, and he's actually going to blitz, which now makes this even better. So just a quick little dip. Now, this time he goes with him, but you see he still has that advantage. He still has that quick advantage. So if you wanted to check down to the back, you can. Spacing, in my opinion, is one of the most underrated plays in the entire game this season, especially with the effectiveness of hitch routes this year. And if they go man-to-man, Crabtree's route, let me show you here, it's going to turn into a deep post, and it actually is going to win against man-to-man. So, again, this is just something little that you can do, but it really does pay off for you in the end. This is a great little play. And as you can see here, Crabtree's route normally does a good job at beating man-to-man coverage. So, again, this is just something very simple that everyone can run. And as you can see here, the slant route against man does good. Against zone, don't throw it. You know, pretty simple. So, anyway, that is the spacing play. And we use it a lot. We do. We use it a lot. The next play, halfback base. What I like to do with this is just run it, and I'll do some fake motions. If they're base aligned, oftentimes what I like to do is I like to motion Amari Cooper out just a few steps just to fake like I'm running divide wheel, when in reality I'm running the halfback base. You know, if they back guys off, it's really a good read. One other play here that I want to show you is the halfback cross screen, and this is going to be the final play from the bunch that we discussed today. We have several more plays to talk about with this. Kansas City's playbook is just really deep, and that's one of the reasons why I like it so much. So we've talked about bunch trail, we've talked about KC divide, talked about stick, spacing, Z-spot, mesh post. We haven't talked about half-back cross screen. We haven't even gotten to bunch curl, and we won't get to that today. But half-back cross screen. So this is something that you can run. And it'll look very similar to the divide wheel. Basically, you're going to slide your line to the right. You can't hot route anybody anyway, but your first read on this play is to Marcel Reese's route. And what you're going to see here is if you can throw this route to Marcel. Now, against zone, you won't be able to. As you can see there, the zone will take it away, right? Most zone coverage will. But if they go man, right, and that's what makes this play really good, against man, Marcel Reese is actually going to win. As you can see, just a quick little read, and there you go. So if it's man coverage, you now have a bailout route, which is nice, and that's what makes it such a good screen pass. Now if it's zone coverage, you're going to be able to hit Latavius Murray here when he cuts to the outside, which again is a nice little screen pass. In my opinion, it's one of the best ones in the game and something that you can definitely utilize. So guys, that's a lot of content. That's an hour and a half, almost an hour and 5 minutes worth of video content breaking down one of the formations, and normally we do this in all of our guides. We have several videos, and today, like I said, you know, this is the content we're taking a look at. This is our base offense. We're going to be in this majority of the game. That's probably why today's video was so lengthy, but there's a lot that you can do with the bunch formation, and so definitely don't ever sell yourself short with it. And that is the bunch content for the Madden Ultimate Team Guide. So, guys, if this video is something that you liked and you would like to see more of, I would highly recommend hitting that subscribe button, because by subscribing, you're going to be able to get access to the rest of this guide. And there are so many formations to get to still. And so a lot of really good content coming soon. We're actually going to break down a popular formation ran by one of the best gamers today, Problem. Definitely looking forward to it. So hope you guys are liking this series, and hopefully you guys enjoy the rest of the content we have for you. And also, guys, the only thing I ask from my subscribers right now, if you're a true follower of my YouTube channel, if you'll do me one favor and just share this video, whether it be on Twitter, whether it be by hitting a like rating, whether it be on Facebook, anything you can do. But show your support so that we can get, we can build up the community here and hopefully help a lot more people. So thank you.